Well, here's a quick example of how to create a frequency distribution within Excel. And what I have here is I have a data file. This is available in your data files. It's called Pay Survey Results or Pay Survey. And what we have are the results of a fictitious survey in which we've asked people where they live and how much they pay or how much they are paid. And so what we'd like to do is put this into a frequency distribution with numeric data. So we're going to have classes and we're going to have the class width. And there's that formula that you can go through. But in this case, we're going to let Excel kind of determine the number of classes. It won't exactly come out to what we would determine if we were to do it mathematically here. But we're going to do that through the pivot table tool. So in order to use the pivot table tool, we first have to make sure that we're in the data, within the database itself, which as you learn a little bit more about Excel, you'll learn about databases. But then I'll go into the insert. I'm going to choose pivot table. And it says, okay, I think this is the data that you want to use to make your pivot table, and that's absolutely correct. And then over in this create pivot table dialog box, it asks us, where do we want to put the result? We'd like to put the result into a new workbook and have a complete new worksheet as the pivot table. So I'm just going to go ahead and click OK. And I have the basis of a pivot table. And if you haven't worked with pivot tables before, you might want to explore it a little bit. They're really easy, really cool. I'm just going to make this really simple, though. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to drag pay down into the values. And as soon as I do, I have sum of pay. With a frequency distribution, I'm not going to be working with sum. I'm going to be working with count. But I'm going to change that in a second. Now, in order to have classes, and I'm going to choose a class width of 2, where we have the lowest pay was 9, the highest one was 27, so we'll do 9 through 11 and so on. I'm going to add pay again, and I'm going to add it as a row heading. Okay, now this surely did not accomplish what I'm wanting. In this case, I have literally every one of the 421 pay survey results listed here, but I'm going to group the data. Before I do that, though, let's change this so instead of being a sum, it's a count. So I just double-click up here where it says sum of pay. I'm going to change it to count. So it says count of pay, and that'll be good enough. We'll just click OK here. So now we have how many individuals reported that particular exact pay rate. That's not what I'm after. I'm after frequency distribution. I do that by grouping within the pivot table. So I'm going to right-click on one of the values. I'm going to choose group. It asks me, okay, here's the starting point. We'll just use the low and the high that we have within the data itself. And this is our class width. And I'm going to go ahead and choose 2 as the class width. So I'll have 9 through 11 and so on. And I'll go ahead and click OK. And there it is. There's my frequency distribution. So in the class of $9 to $11 an hour, I have 35. Down here at the bottom, between 27 and 29, I only have 1 because the highest one was $27.10. Now, the cool thing about Excel is if I wanted to make a graph of this, a histogram, or close to a histogram, I can just go into stay in the data, go into the Insert tab, and I'm going to go ahead and click Call. And I am using Office 2013 for this particular demonstration. It looks a little bit different than 2010, which some of the other demo videos have been, but there's not a whole lot of difference here. So I'm going to choose Insert Column Chart. I'm going to choose 2D Column Chart, and there I have it. Okay, so there's a graphical representation of the numeric data. In here we have different classes and class width. So as you can see, it's very, very easy to do using the pivot table feature within Excel.